Welcome to another My Two Good Hands video. What are we talking today? We're talking woodworking or we're talking Corbels. Look what we did. There you go. I'm going to show you how we easily made that very inexpensively. Don't pay $50 a piece for Corbels for your house. Here we go. One piece of wood that I paid 12 bucks for made four of these. So think about that. In a little bit of time, we'll give you the tools listed below in the descriptions. So don't forget to like and subscribe. Catch you in the next woodworking project. But watch this one. Simple to do. I know you can do it. So we measured our board. Our board is 7 1/4. So we got to set up our fence to be half of that. So half of 7 is 3 1/2. Half of 1/4 is 1/8. But we're going to go a 16th. 9/16 we're set up for. So we set the blade for 3 9/16 to cut it totally in half. Let's get ready to cut. Then we'll get our templates. So let's fire up the table saw. If you don't have a table saw, you can buy the narrow ones or a lot of scroll saw work, cut them out. I always do this so I can check it. Come in here and check. Yep, right down the center. So, we got a pen to mark the wood, got our patterns. You can cut these out of wood, you can cut them out of cardboard, you can cut them out of a little bit of sheet metal, doesn't really matter. Just carve them out and use the same ones. If you use one to make the next one, next one, next one, you slowly change them. So stay with the same pattern. Go mark them up. Our plan here is to make a set of these. So we are going to lay our pattern down, our first one. We're going to flush the edge there. And we're going to just come in and trace it. Oops. Trace it out. Oh, so we have four of the big ones, two of the small ones. We're going to put big, small, big when we put it together. So let's get them chopped up and then we will take them downstairs on a scroll saw. Next step is to start working these apart by coming in here and bringing our saw down and cutting them apart. There you go, we've got to reset our saw, cut the other side, but you get the idea. We're going to make as many rough cuts on here as we can with the saw. Then it's off to the scroll saw to cut our profiles. So here's our setup. We have our shop vac hooked into our scroll saw so we don't make a lot of dust. I will run the shop vac and scroll saw together. Scroll saw is set here to clamp the wood nicely. So we're going to go ahead and cut, and then you can watch at high speed what takes me 15 minutes. Remember, a bandsaw would be better for this, but I don't have one. So got our parts. I remember we made these thicker on one end than the other. That's because of our house. You wouldn't need to do that on yours if your house was different than mine. Nail gun. Nail gun is set up with 2-inch nails. These are 3/4 thick, so 3/4 and 3/4, inch and a half, another, and then another 3/4. So you're at 2 1/4 inches, and you got 2-inch nails. Hook this into the air. We're going to glue this up. You're going to get wet. You want to make sure you glue them with outdoor glue, but mine don't get wet. It's under the porch. I'm just going to put some glue on here like this. Come around. Now you can see how that worked. We're going to take it and we're going to put it right on the edge here. And we'll use a board to line it up here. Then we're going to put another batch of glue on this part of this one here. There you go. Much better than the first one. Welcome back to another My Two Good Hands video. Hey, we're in the middle of our corbel. Remember we cut the corbels out the first half of this video? Now we're going to put them on the house. So don't forget here, I did have the wife paint these. She did a beautiful job. If you look at that, it just looks marvelous. We're going to put them up. The wider part goes up. So got our stool and everything out. Let's get them up. This, it's got to be squared up and lined up. So get that in, come over this way, get this one in. Oh, that's pretty good. This has got to go a little more now. Go. So when you what do you think of that? Let's take a walk around and take a look at it. All right, so here you can see the before and after. There's your before and there's your after. You can see what that looks like. Kind of dresses up that porch a lot, don't it? So don't forget, like and subscribe, post notifications on.